In this lesson, we are going to use this moisture sensor to check the level of moisture in the soil and water our plant. I'm not going to turn on the actual water because it will be very messy, because we have already had a water pump lesson. Please refer to that lesson. Here I'm just using a buzzer and we are going to test it. When there is enough wet and wet, 780 analog zero to the motor driver. Then from this positive, which says 12 volts, we are, so let me just remove it. Still there is moisture. I will dry it up. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. And in this lesson, now we are going to use this moisture sensor. If we go to a learning project, analog read and measure soil moisture, 4.4. This moisture sensor, it has three pins. One is ground, the other is VCC, which will be connected to 5 volts, and then the output will be connected to analog zero. Because we are reading analog, depending on the moisture amount, we will have some value, and we can set our moisture level, and then based on the amount, we can take action. So a pump can be turned on, or a relay, or light, whatever you have. So because this is a moisture sensor, perhaps if the moisture is too much, maybe you turn on a fan so it can remove the moisture, or maybe it can turn on the pump to bring water. And here is the moisture sensor. This is just an operational amplifier, and there is a capacitive measurement. There is one pin. We have one path here at the middle, and there is another path surrounding it. So the distance between these two is an empty spot where the moisture will affect the capacitive charge between the two of the paths. There is enough moisture between these two paths, the capacity of the capacitor will change, and we are amplifying it using this op-amp as a voltage, and we are measuring it using Arduino to take action. So when it is dry, we get one value at the output. When it is moist, the output will change. So a basal plant. This smells good. I'm going to measure the moisture. Now let's open the project by clicking on File, Open, to wherever you download it. In my case, it's SunFounder, download SunFounder 3-in-1 kit, learning project, and 4.4, measure soil moisture. Double click and open the file. So the code is very simple. We initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud, and inside the setup, that's done. And then inside the loop, we use analog read, and then we use analog read to read analog zero pin. The result is stored as an integer, which is between 0 to 1023, and then we use serial println. This value is printed on the serial monitor, and we have 10 millisecond delay. So this will give you just a vague value, which I'm going to explain it in the next section of this tutorial. Here is a wiring diagram. Ground is connected to ground. VCC is connected to 5 volts, and A out or analog out is connected to zero. To connect the sensor, because the connector is like that, I've used three male to male. This side is male and the other side is as well male. Here is the wiring. Black is black, red I've connected to a red, yellow is blue because in the diagram it was showing as blue. This black is connected to ground, red is connected to 5 volts, this yellow is now blue, and blue is connected to analog zero. Now I have here water, and the code is loaded, and we are constantly reading the value. It shows around 940, and I'm immersing it in water, and let's see what we read. Now it's about 890, 870. As you can see, as the time passes, it's being reduced. 840, 830, 820, 800, 780. So let's just wait, and if I remove it back, it goes to 800. So we can see that I've immersed it in water and we are reading. Let me just dry it up. You see, it's already dried up. When you're immersing it in water, be careful, these components will die. So I have enough water here up to a certain point that even if I immerse it fully, it doesn't go beyond this point. So now when I remove it, as you can see, the number is very high, which means when it is dry, the number is high. When it is wet, the number is low. So first we have to learn this and come up with something. So you have to experiment and find out what value is considered dry and what value is wet. This smells good. I'm going to insert this into the soil. As you can see, we are reading around 880, and let's insert it. To show you, I've inserted it that much, and as you can see, we are reading around 800, and it is decreasing, 790. Oh, this smells good. To 790 or 780. Now, you will touch the soil, and you see, you will come up with a number, that which number represents wet and which number represents dry. For this purpose, I'm going to pour some water in that area, see what happens. But, okay, now there is enough water now, 750. So lower numbers means wet. Now it's fully wet with water. That's why we are reading around 740. Because if I wait, it might decrease. Let's not worry. Let me just remove it. So 850, so it will go up to 900 if I dry it up or clean it. So now let's go to another spot which I have not watered recently. It was maybe this morning or so. I've just inserted it, so 750, 740, 840, so it's being reduced as the time passes. This is around 820. Now, when it is around 820, you can turn on a water pump to water it up. When it reaches, for example, 750, you can stop the water pump. Now, because we know the values that it works, now we are going to insert it in soil and also turn on a buzzer, and I'm going to show you how to control the water pump from a previous project. I will show you the code. And here is our code. I've defined an alarm pin of type integer with a value 2. This is where our pump or alarm or buzzer is connected. Then we are reading the moisture pin. Moisture pin analog 0. We have two values. When the value is greater than 860, it's we defined it as dry value, and any value below 750 is our wet value. So you can experiment with these to find out which value works for your environment or the soil. And then we have a variable called watering with an initial value of false. So this is just holding the state of watering. And inside the setup, we use pin mode, and alarm pin is set as an output, so we can control it as an output and send signal to the buzzer or relay or whatever device we have. Inside the loop, we use analog read, moisture pin. So, so let's change it to moisture pin. Using analog read, we read moisture pin, and then the value will be stored in sensor value. After that, we use, let me show you, we use this. If sensor value is greater than dry value, and here it says, and watering is not, this means not true. So currently we are not watering. Then we say digital light alarm pin high. So this will turn on the water pump or alarm. And then we update the variable with a value true, because we have turned on the watering. So we have to say watering equal true. Then we print this text, watering. Then we say if the sensor value is smaller than watering and watering is true, then we send the we turn the pin off, and we also set the value of watering to off. Here it was on, now we turned it off, and then we print this sensor with space, watering stopped in here. Then if watering is not true, which means we are not watering, then we say the value, we set the value growing, and we put the value and we type this, the word growing here. And after 1 second, everything will be repeated again. Now here is the demonstration. As you can see, the value is 730, which means it's below 750. It's too wet. So the pump is stopped at the moment. But if you want to do, if it is below 750, we can also turn on. But for us, it's just watering. So it's working at the moment. The sensor is in here. Let me just remove it. It is dirty. Okay, so let me just remove it. Still, there is moisture. I will dry it up. As soon as I dry it up, the value is 862. And as you can see, it says watering. Now the pump can be connected. Instead of this buzzer, we could have a pump or relay that is controlling a water pump or a pump that we just shown in previous lessons. So the water is watering it, and until it reaches back to wet. Now I'm just immersing it. This area is very wet. So when it senses that it is wet, just wait. And when it goes below 750, the water pump will stop. So to make it faster, I'm going to drop some water here. Wait for it, don't worry. So, have such a 745, so below 750. And as you can see, now the pump is stopped. Now, even if the number goes high, the pump will not turn on, because the pump will turn on only when it goes above 860. So you see a 750, 751, now the pump is not working. It has to reach 860, because we don't want to turn on and off the pump anytime, every time when the number changes. We want it when it reaches at this drying level, then it will turn on. This is a small water pump where we can connect a pipe here so it can suck the water from the bottom and pump it via this pipe hole to wherever we want it. This is a pipe that we can connect it like that to be secure, and this will be connected to the motor driver. So the same as before, this needs high power, so we send very weak signal from Arduino to the motor driver, and motor driver will send strong signal to control the rotation of this pump or motor. Here is the wiring. If I click on 1.4, this is pumping. We are connecting exactly the same as before. You see the same L298 in, and the motor is connected exactly the same way. Wiring is the same way, so there is no difference. And here, the two wires of N3 and N4 are connected to the same point. Everything is the same, except we are just replacing the wheel motor to pump motor. For the water pump project, all the wiring is exactly the same, except we replace the wheel driver with a water pump and make sure to connect the red on this side and black on this side. Now, let me show you how we can combine the pump control code with this soil moisture sensor code. Let's go and open it. 1.4 pumping, and then open it. So this is one code. So this is the soil measurement code, and this is the pumping code. Let's save it to another project. Save as. I'm just adding pump to it. Top two pin have been defined here. I'm copying them and pasting it here. That now inside the setup, we just need to copy the pin definition. I'm copying it and pasting it here. So this is for our pin A and pin B, which we have defined pin 9 and 10. Inside the loop, under this condition where it says watering now, let's just put this. So this is now turning one pin high, one pin low, and the pump will run. And to turn it off, we turn off both. In this line, you can see this line is for turning it off. Just put it below this and make this also low. So this will keep both of them off. Both pin off and motor will stop.